Hey everyone, I'm Alexis, the Ego Queen. Love me, I know you do. And welcome back to another episode of Dark Heresy. Once again, I'm joined by Viggy and friends, and from here on, I'm going to let Viggy take over.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I am Viggy the GM, and welcome back to the Queen's Court. When we last left our heroes, arriving at the Screaming Wheel Cantina, our intrepid acolytes enter the rundown establishment, taking in the squalor and misery of the common men and hive ganger alike. In the corner, the leader of the baby faces is tormenting a manufacturing worker and promptly stabs him in the gut. Approaching the well-dressed killer, Ren attempted to do business and persuade the leader to meet at a discreet location. At the bar itself, a bulky tech priest sits and takes prodigious notes. He approaches the warman and introduces himself as Bal Tarvok, a possible servant of Inquisitor Hunt. He offers to lead them towards this discreet location. And we return. Now, you were about to set off towards this discreet location. You know it as the Bal Tarvok describes this location as Three Stakes Rest, a rundown part of the middle hive. Not quite into the lower hive yet, but you're getting there.
Very interesting.
If you wish to discuss plans, now would be the time to do it.
So this tech priest is going to lead us there. I want us to keep a lookout for locations where we can ambush them in case worst comes to worst.
Fair enough.
Does that sound good with everybody?
I think that maybe Harlock should not show himself in case they don't quite know he's with us.
Fair enough. He did come in after us, after all.
As well as Ball.
Indeed. Ball, what kind of area are we looking at here?
As you walk further down into the mid-hive, the place becomes increasingly ragged and run down. But the good thing about this location is that there is less foot traffic, meaning you are going in not quite noticed by anyone except the beggars and the rats, if you can notice the rats. Roll awareness to notice rats.
No.
Fair enough. You automatically fail.
I don't want to look at rats. That's gross.
The rats are carrying the bubonic plague. You're infected. You all die.
Oh, great.
Holy shit. I finally succeed at an awareness test to see rats.
Yeah, of course. The less important the test, the more likely you are to succeed.
Please, please, if you don't have awareness, just at least pick up the basic ones. You don't take the negative 20 penalty to it, because awareness is the most rolled skill in a game.
Best kid. Well, that's the funny part.
Perception. Wait, what? How the... I don't even...
That's what you're here for, but you can't pass your test.
Fuck you.
5 minutes in and we're arguing.
Of course. Yeah, it's all good fun, but let's keep going. So, this area has, like I described, mostly rats and beggar people that are... hold on, who got the... Yeah, Toby, seeing how you actually made it, I am going to give you a result, as strange as it sounds. One of the beggar men, you notice, is holding a pack of low sticks and smoking it. You recognize the brand.
Oh. It's, curious.
Indeed. Do you continue onward?
I approach the man.
The older man, with his, scraggly, unkempt beard and a mop of hair upon his head, not literal mop, but you catch my meaning, looks back up to you and says, "Ah, greetings, good sir. What brings you to these parts? They are quite dangerous."
We're meeting a group of unique individuals to this area.
Keep a close eye on your keep a close eye on that chainsword of yours. You may need it in these parts. Very unsavory characters.
Has anyone passed through here before us, by chance, good sir?
Before here? Well, there was this foppish group of people that passed some time ago.
Do they
ago.
Look like they belonged to mid-upper hive?
Upper hive? Upper hive, if I had to guess, though they did stroll around like they owned the place.
Did they have masks covering their eyes?
They did indeed. Most of their face, too.
How many?
About four of them. So that would correspond with the number of people back at the Screaming Wheel.
Did you overhear anything interesting?
Other than then talking about some interesting lady that they met, they were laughing quite heartily.
Were they carrying anything with them? Like anything distinguishable?
Not that I remember. They were... one of them was playing with a knife in his hands, but don't remember anything else.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Oh, Emperor's blessings.
Emperor bless you.
Indeed, indeed. And he hands you a low stick back for your kindness. Just a single one. He keeps the pack. He appears to be halfway through it.
Have a good day.
And a quick nod of the head. You keep going.
And I rush back to the group and fill on everyone what he told me.
Most interesting. So if they were not obviously carrying anything, it must be either small, already there, or non-existent.
And the princess head helping the common man was worthless.
Princess also can't enact mercy on a dying man.
Shut up about that.
No, I will not. Your hesitation could get you killed or anyone else here killed.
It won't I've had enough men again.
Under my watch die.
I'll believe you, princess.
Can we get past the arguing and get to the part where we start shooting people, please?
Oh, are you going to shoot or are you going to chop down another tree?
Right after I put a bullet right between your stupid eyes.
I'm just going to something to do. Jab to Toby in the ribs with my elbow and just look at him in a calm down kind of way.
I take out the low stick that the beggar gave me and just light it.
Oh, by the Omnicide, this will get us nowhere. We must focus on the objective.
Rust Bucket is right.
Again, my twitching starts with my eyes and fingers, and I slowly tap my hip.
I notice the twitching, and I offer him a blow stick to calm your nerves.
I take it in my hand and crush it.
Feeling calm yet?
Not calm.
Does it help you calm down? Crushing, crushing.
Out of character. Out of character, yes? Really quickly. Rin has no idea this guy's name.
Did he not introduce himself?
Even we if mentioned he it. Introduced himself, she wasn't listening.
Oh, right.
Fucking shocking.
Yeah, yeah.
So, out of character, you want me to just give the name?
It's
Baltavarius Tarvok, or also known, or you can just call him. Most people just call him Ball.
Okay, continue.
Testicle, it is.
Pinecone testicle it is.
All right. You move along into the pre-described location, and you find yourself in an abandoned, what looks to be a overseer's shack. It overlooks a manufacturum that stretches further down. And we will move us straight to here. So, if you could zoom out. And place yourself around here.
I could actually zoom in a little bit.
Whoop.
Oh, right. It's this.
Also, I need marching order.
Hold on, I'm trying to add myself. It's not working for me.
Go to where you usually... click on your character sheet and click your name and drag it.
It'll hold down and drag.
Yeah, there you go. And let me just make you a bit bigger. There you go.
I should probably be marching in the front.
Yeah, since she has the...
Yeah. Oop, there you go. Excellent.
That works.
All right.
Assuming this is a door in front of us that's closed.
Yes.
It is indeed closed.
Okay. I'm going to knock on the door.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. Let me... Oh, shit. Let me... There you go. And the door slides to the side in a screeching motion.
I'm going to walk in up to this point.
Mm-hmm.
And just gaze around the room.
As you look around this overseer's office that has been clearly stripped out of most of the furnishings, only a pedestal in the middle with a blue cloth over it is visible in the middle of the room with the man who is no doubt Skinner, the leader of this gang. The rest of the gang appears settled in, leaning up against walls, sitting on crates, smoking low sticks. They appear supremely bored.
All right. Only
Skinner appears mused in the slightest. At least his grin would say such. Also, you guys can move yourself about just at a reasonable pace. Can you guys hear the background audio?
Yes.
Indeed.
Can you actually turn it up just a wee bit?
So you might have to go to the gear on your top right and go to master music volume level and turn that up yourself. It might be turned down and let it fall.
I have it up pretty high, so I'm not going to touch it.
Yeah, mine's all the way up.
Okay, so I'm going to bump the audio.
It's not super loud to begin with.
Yeah, well, I don't want it loud, just
that
noticeable. Okay, fine. Excellent. So, Skinner puts his arms out in a theatrical gesture and says, "Welcome, Lady Roseless, to my fabulous display. I sure hope the trip wasn't too much of a bother."
It wasn't too bad.
Excellent. Now, did you bring the payment? You have said payment. You can just show it.
I'm more interested in your goods first. But yes, I do have the payment, if it's necessary.
Excellent. Let us get straight to business. And he moves the cloth. On the pedestal, you see before you a three-fingered skeletal hand with claws on the end. Tobian, roll for me a fear test. You have a plus 10 because you have resistance to it.
Just let me find it.
Yeah, you just roll willpower with a plus 10.
Okay.
You might want to reroll that.
Fate point? Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Good. Good. Well, sweet baby emperor.
What the fuck?
Yeah,
last episode. Yeah, let's, yeah, we have some, rolls to do. Hold on.
We're all gonna die.
Hold on.
I haven't cast any psychics yet.
So. He hasn't done anything too bad yet, so let's see. That is 5 degrees of failure, so let's get a D100 plus 50.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, fuck me.
I need the result before I say what happens.
Okay, it's not too bad.
108. Here we go. before the effect of the fear test kicks in, hold on. As soon as the cloth comes off the skeletal hand, Tobian, this is from your point of vision. As soon as you blink, you find yourself in a misty forest. A path of bones running through it appears beneath your feet, as if not being laid there beforehand, but simply by virtue that you tread upon it. Between the trees, graves and grotesques are littered about as if growing alongside them. Dark shapes writhe in the shadows of tombstones and grave markers. Ancien, come the night, blow, color, blow. As the whispering becomes indistinguishable, it ceases as quickly as it began, and you are back. However, the character totally overcome, the character screams and vomits uncontrollably for 1d5 rounds. During this time, he can do nothing and drops anything he's holding. Afterward, until the end of the encounter, the character can only take a single half action each turn. So, 1d5, please. You just r/1d5. Is that right? /r/1d5?
Yes, 1d5. Might have to do r/1d5.
Okay.
There you go. So for 15 seconds, because a turn is 5 seconds, you vomit uncontrollably onto the floor. Spoon, if you could find something appropriate, that would be great. Keep it. Just we keep it in our minds. So also roll for me.
I'm on the ground vomiting.
Yeah, vomiting profusely. Roll for me two separate 1d5s.
Me?
No, Toby.
Okay.
Toby in. 1 and 5. That's 1 corruption and 5 insanity. Let me just pop that onto your... Hey, you're the one... you're the one with the bad stuff. So, advancements, and you go insanity 11, and corruption... 21. More stuff will be rolled later.
So this is as the cloth is coming off, he falls to the ground and vomits.
Vomits uncontrollably. You can also roll for me, Toby, you can also roll for me an awareness plus 20 as you're doing this. You did not make it.
Yep.
So, does anyone respond to this uncontrollable vomiting?
I'm gonna look over, see my friend, throw up, turn back to, whatever his name was, I forgot right now.
Skinner.
And say, by the Emperor's teeth, what is this thing?
One of a kind, as I said.
A
not
B.
Hmm?
I'm gonna go over to Toby and check on him.
I love that we can determine whether something's an actual artifact or not, depending on how badly our psyker flips his shit. It's great. It's like a fucking detector.
He's
a lightning rod for corruption. He's great.
He's a lightning rod for corruption. Look, better hand to me, man. That's all. Look, better hand.
Hey, wood, you should be hugger.
One at a time.
I'm gonna roll medic on him.
Go ahead. Do you have Medicaid?
He doesn't have Medicaid.
No, I thought.
You can try, even if it's untrained. Just don't bungle it up too bad.
Yeah, you take a negative 20 to any untrained skill.
Yeah, it happens automatically, so keep that in mind. Yeah. So you don't have to input it. Wait. Oh yeah, never mind. I was looking at something wrong.
Hey!
How?
Damn, that's pretty good. You reach into Tobian's medikit, careful to not touch the orb. Actually, with this, roll an awareness, plus 30.
Don't be a spoon and fuck it up.
No, and you fucked it up. What is it with awareness tests in this group?
We are not very aware.
I'm trying to give you you people these checks and you're failing them. Whatever.
Look, if it was Pathfinder, I'd have like a plus 20 something in my fucking perception, but it isn't, so I don't.
Probably. Yeah, you go into the Medicaid of Topian's Medicaid, reach in and put a pill in his mouth to try and calm his inside. I'm not actually sure if there's a pill that does that, but fuck it, 40k.
Yeah.
But Tobian calms down and stops shaking so violently. Now, if that is if this isn't display enough of this item's uniqueness, I'm not sure what else I can do.
I'm going to take notes about what happens, basically about from the cloth of being unveiled to what it does to Tobian.
Actually, yeah, excellent. Ren, that question was directed at you.
Okay. What? Where did you get this?
I got this from my supplier, a man in the trade sable. I shan't disclose of his location or his name, for that would be bad for business. But take note that this is the genuine article. It is clearly... It's fine. Looking at this clawed skeletal hand, you can see that it is clearly not human. It is of Xenos origins. No tests required.
I'm gonna grab my bolt, my las pistol, aim it at his head, and demand that he tells me where it is. Using command.
This is command. Hold on, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it's equal. You get a plus 10, and he will resist with willpower with a plus 10 as well.
I should have asked before I rolled. Can I use my ability to auto-pass that?
You can, and it uses your willpower bonus, not your fellowship. I mistook that last time.
Oh, okay, so...
Yeah, it's only 3 degrees of success, but you can use it.
Okay, so can we disregard that last one, or are we going to keep that?
The other one, like the last fate point you used? No, we just roll with it.
The fate points I've counted since last section.
No, let's just hold on. You have what, 2 left now? You've used 2 already.
Yep.
Yeah. So, let's say that you disregard the other one.
Okay. So I am going to use a fate point to use command.
Yeah.
And demand so, that he tells me.
Hold on, I'm just going to real quick roll a willpower test from him with a 10 and submit. What did he get? He got... Oh, he made it, but he didn't make it well enough. Wait, hold on. Did you roll or... Oh yeah, you disregarded the roll. That's right. Sorry, yeah. I didn't see that. Yeah. Never mind. That is different. So, he makes it, but with too few degrees of success. This is an opposed test. He mockingly raises his hands and says, "Oh my, a hostile takeover, have we?" Holthane warned me about this. Well, sadly, I'm afraid that... Also, has anyone taken note of that name?
Halson?
I have.
Hold on, I'll write it here.
Yeah.
Holthane. Like that. At least that's the name that he gave. He probably didn't mean to give it, but... such was the idea. Alright. So. He shakes his hand. Roll for me an awareness, everyone that isn't Ren.
So everyone that isn't? Okay.
Yeah. So, excluding her.
Yeah.
Holy crap, you didn't make it. Harlock makes it, finally.
Fucking nice.
Alright.
All right. 1 second.
Yeah.
Trying to find where. Yeah. Oh, there's awareness.
Yeah, it's up top. Damn, you don't have awareness. Shame. Alright, so for Tobian and Baltarvok, you do not notice that the other three are putting their hands into their different clothing, no doubt going for a weapon or two. So, everyone roll initiative, because Skinner is going to initiate this one. So, let's get it on. Let's clear this, remove all turns, clear, and let me roll for him. So, everyone, yeah, it's go to your sheet, and it... It's on your sheet below your characteristics next to your fate point. You roll the agility, and I will add the agility bonus to your score. So check your agility bonus, which is the 10 number of your agility, and add that to your turn order. You should be able to change it on the screen itself.
Wait, I did the wrong thing.
Alright, so...
Yeah, I keep getting an attempt to roll a command looking for a value of a selected token.
You have to select the token.
Okay.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah, so check your agility and add it to that because the thing doesn't work properly.
Plus 5. Oh.
Plus 3.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Mine didn't. Like,
yeah, it doesn't add. So you do it manually. Yeah. Wait, you rolled an 8, didn't you?
Yeah, and then you said plus 5, right?
No. Your agility bonus. It's. You check your sheet, and it's the 10 of your agility score. So for you, it would be 3 because you have 35. Yeah. So
just
it would
keep
be.
In mind, I can't do the pluses or minuses because those are the hotkeys.
Yeah, so I'll just change it into 11.
Thank you.
Okay, so we will move this guy up here, this guy up here. Oh, snap! Like, 3 of you have 13. So, Brecht, Harlock, and Toby, roll for me a d10 to see which one of you goes first. Wait. Spoon, you already rolled initiative once.
Oh, did I roll it twice?
Yeah, you got one.
Oh, okay, I didn't see it. Well, because I got the syntax error thing as well, so I assumed it was...
Oh, it did work, so hold on, I'll just bump it down to 5. Yeah. Man. Alright, that gets rid of one of you, so...
It gave me, like, 5 paragraphs of error.
Yeah, that's odd. So, let me see. Brecht and Toby. Brecht goes first. Excellent. Okay, now let me roll for these dudes. So, they are here.
Just had to pull out the bolt pistol.
Well, bolt pistols have not arrived yet, so...
I mean, run.
3... He got a 7. That's a 10. So he goes here. And then the other guys, I'm just going to do... You see those guys that look the same? They're twins, so they're going to act in tandem. So,
oh, great.
I'm just going to have the same initiative order for those guys. So 5 plus 3, that's 8. 8 and... Enter and whoop. There we go. So, first up, Brecht, you are up. What do you wish to do?
I'm going to V, for the laser pointer attached to my laser pointer.
Yeah. Hold on,
plus 5, right?
Hold on, I'm fixing something. Could you try measuring again? Because I saw a deficiency that needed addressing. Measure again.
Is it finally showing your meters? Hey, there we go, nice.
There we go. I had to check that because, like, feet? What is this?
Well, last time we tried it, it wasn't working, remember? But Roll20 was kind of stupid, so we just gave up.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, so I fixed it now. So what was the question, Brecht?
For my laser pointer attachment,
it has to be a single shot. You get a plus 10 on a single shot. When you declare a standard attack, you get one shot fired.
All right, and is calling shots a thing, or?
Called shots are a thing. You have to declare the body part.
You take a penalty, don't you?
Yeah, you take a minus 20 penalty unless you have Precision Killer, which is the talent that Harlock has.
Oh, I'm not gonna bother then.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna shoot at this dude.
All right. So you are in short range. It takes a half action. Did you come in gun in hand? I'm gonna guess no.
No.
No, okay, so half action to equip your weapon, and another half action for a standard attack.
So, roll to hit?
Yes.
Do I do the plus 10, or does the...
The standard attack should handle that by itself. Does it... It asks for... So go to your weapon. So in gear... You should click on the hit on your last gun.
Oh, okay.
I forgot I had a hand cannon. Should have taken that out.
I'm at point blank range.
You are at short range. Point blank range is 3 meters or less.
Oh, okay.
Indeed, that is what you're looking at, Alexis.
Yeah.
So for rate of fire attack type, it's
standard attack.
And then do I add anything for the modifier? Or?
You add plus 10 for the range and plus 10 for your red dot side. So plus 20. Does it ask for range?
Yeah, it already did range.
All right, the modifier is plus 10 for your red dot side. That's a 55 on a 76. He is going to attempt to dodge it. So let me grab a dodge from him. So dodge. And he doesn't get a bonus. He rolls. And he fails horribly. So roll damage.
He rolls into the shot.
It was going straight for his gut. He bent over and shot himself in the head.
Yeah. So, 7 damage to his... You hit on 55. That's reversing into 55. So you hit him in the body. It doesn't have penetration yet. I have some sad news for you. You do no damage.
Oh, well.
Hold on. Wait, I'm looking at you. Let me double check the other guy. That is... Hold on. Oh, you do 1 point of damage. He has a single wound taken. So let me fix that. So it would be dupe and dupe. When you click... Yeah, when you click your character, do a whole bunch of circles pop up?
Yeah.
Usually.
Yeah, so click on the red circle and input your wounds there, just so it's easier to track. So check your wounds on your character sheet and input them. And then it will, and when you click it again, you can input the amount of damage later, and it would keep track of it for you. I'm doing it for them just so it's easier. Oop, there you go. Also, I will be explaining a lot of things because this is first combat.
So in the red one, I'll write
18? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
12. Okay, let's see. You have done your turn. You have done your point of damage. Demon Bait, you're up.
There it comes.
Remember, if you're going to do a test, you have to roll a willpower. You have a minus 10 from your vomiting, and you also have your insanity stuff from the attempted possession. So every test you need want to do needs a willpower test, or you get another minus 10. You are a wreck of a man.
Give me a second.
Are you picking a weapon to use?
Could I hit both the twins with one grenade?
Hold on, it's blast 5. Let me just measure that out. So,
that's also in the measurement.
So if you hit here, yeah, you should be... Actually, you can hit 3 of them.
Jesus.
Yep. Going for the grenade.
Oh boy, this is... this may go poorly. So before you do anything, you half-action equip your grenade. Then you half-action throw it as a standard attack. Before you throw, roll a willpower test at a minus 10 because of vomiting. You make it. Excellent. You don't get an additional minus 10. So, roll for me ballistic skill with a minus 10.
Please tell me you're going to say something before you fling your grenade.
Grenade out! Get down!
Q. Alright.
I'm sorry for metagaming that, but...
Yeah.
Oh, also, declare for me the location that you're going to throw the grenade. I need to know.
It Okay, ping.
Shit.
You got it?
Shit, I wasn't looking. Sorry. Ping again? There you go. Okay, so that that square below, above the one of the twins. Okay, that's good. So, roll the ballistic skill test.
Trying to find it on the sheet.
It's any characteristics.
Please don't screw this up.
It is below your weapon skill. There's a high chance of fucking up.
Does Tobian count as cover for me?
If you were a limp, an unconscious body would count, but he does not.
Well, he probably will be soon.
Where is it? I can't find it.
It's below weapon skill.
It's on your player sheet. It's on your character sheet. Player sheet. It's the main one. It's under characteristics, weapon skill, ballistic skill, strength, intelligence, all that shit. First page.
Yeah.
Okay, there it is.
You just click I'm ballistic nodding. Skill.
Yeah. The problem with grenades is that you don't roll to hit. You just straight up roll ballistic skill. Whew! Wait, that wasn't with a minus 10.
Oh. Then.
Oh yeah, it doesn't ask for a modifier, so we'll just... Wait, did it ask for a modifier? Actually, if you want to re-roll the test, you got a... you needed a 28 to hit, so... Do you wish to fate point this?
Yes.
Alright.
Oh god, so, this is gonna be bad.
This could be bad.
Pucker factor 10.
Damn it! So close! You needed a... Wait, what?
Close only counts of horseshoes and hand grenade. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh yeah, it keeps...
Want me to refresh my page and do it, or...?
No, it's fine. I was just reading it wrong, because I kept failing to apply the minus 10 for vomiting. So, it hits... So, the destination was here. I am now going to roll the scatter die, and that is 1d10. So, I go here, and it goes 8. Which is down, and then I roll a d5, which is 1d5, and come on, oh, 2. So it scatters 2 meters. So 1, 2, and let me just measure out, which still hits him, and it barely scrapes from you. So, actually, you hit all of them.
Yay.
Does it actually... Am I safe where I am because of cover?
You are safe because it doesn't actually
reach.
It doesn't reach you, so...
Then I'm gonna stand there like a badass with my pistol drawn.
Boom. But you're not a cool guy because you're looking at the explosion. Do you look at the explosion?
I'm staring this guy in the face.
Well, she's a chick, so...
So, roll for me 2d10 for damage. Actually, just click the grenade thingy and roll damage.
Holy shit.
That's 19. Not
plus
bad.
Plus 2 penetration.
Yeah. Man,
I just fight the whole room.
Not quite.
For almost.
I'm gonna have to do some real quick math. So I think that this guy up top is totally dead because he takes that's pen
so
two.
This one's dead.
Let me see, I'm doing some real quick math. He takes minus 2, minus 4. Yep, straight dead. This guy is Boop. This guy is dead. And okay. This guy, right, the guy below him is going to try and attempt to dodge. Actually, the rules for rolling, for dodging grenades, he needs to move his agility bonus. So I put him right and mit. Does he make it? He fails horribly, so he's dead too.
That's actually kind of sad.
Yeah, well, it looks like you're going to completely own this battle by yourself. So
born together, die together.
Fucking grenade.
Grenades do work.
Grenade spam meta. Works in all games.
I was about to say, if I fucking Grenadier and Pathfinder, I could roll
This guy fails his dodge as well, and he's also dead. Now, it is time for the leader to make his roll.
Is it please? Wrong? I'm rooting for him.
No, not wrong.
I kind of want you to go to
wait,
put
is he going to attempt to dodge?
Head.
Yes.
Do I get a chance of overwatching him?
You have not declared Overwatch.
No, not Overwatch. Do I get a shot of action or something like that?
No.
There's no attack of opportunity in their curiosity.
There is, if you leave melee. If you leave melee combat, you get an attack of opportunity.
Okay, I got you.
Yes, so he will attempt to dodge. And does he make it? Whew, he makes it. Easy. Okay, so... with everyone else dead, he is going to dodge. 1, 2, 3, 4. Down here. And
so you're still with him.
And boo. And he's done. He's done with his reaction, that is. Tarvok, do you want to try and top that?
I don't think I'll be able to, but I just have a couple questions. Can I move, take a shot, and yell at Toby for a moment?
That is a half action, and free action. Yes, you can.
How far can I move?
Sure. Actually, hold on. I'm going to roll to see if the item gets hit. It's a 50-50, so...
That's what I was about to yell at before.
Yeah, I'm going to... R/RD100. 25. The item does not get hit. Excellent. So,
all right, so
you can half action move, which is 3 for you, I think. Let me check. So it's, yeah, you have 36 agility. So you can half action move 3 meters. A square counts as a meter, so just keep that in mind. Using Blood Bowl rule, so into square, into square, into square. So if you run in a circle, you can still move 3.
Go. I move up next to.
You can.
I then call out to Toby, you fool, you'll damage the artifact. Watch where you're throwing those things.
Hold on. There's a problem. You can't. Did you have your weapon in your hand?
I had it in my hand since we've been in the bar when I mentioned it.
Fair enough. So, take your, go to your gear on your and find your ranged your sub revolver and click on the hit. Do you get the standard?
I have full aim, no aim, and half aim.
No aim. Since you're out of turns, out of actions if you want to shoot.
All right, so what's the range?
The range is point blank because you are 3 meters away from him.
Next time I'll shoot
rate of fire is just,
what was that?
Okay, so it's just a standard shot?
Yeah, standard attack.
And any modifiers?
No,
I don't think I have any.
Everything has been input, so. Wait. That can't be right. you should have a plus 30 from point blank and another plus 10 from standard attacks, so you should have made that. Okay, I'll take the roll and do the math from there. So you have a, let's see, your ballistic skill is 37 plus that. So you should have you needed a 77 to hit. You got a 57, so you have 3 degrees of success. And 75 is, hold on. Let me see, hit locations. So that is 75 is left, right leg. So that would be roll for me damage. Also, an important thing to note, if you want to, you can exchange your degrees of success for the damage die you roll. So if you say roll 5 degrees of success, but you only roll a 1 for damage, you can swap that out for your degrees of success. All right, let's see. You shot him in the right leg, 7 damage, pen 3. So let me check his location. So you do 1 and... that is 3, so that's 4, so you do 3 wounds to him. I will modify that, minus 3, boop, there we go. All right, you hit him in the thigh of his leg, but his armor appears to absorb most of the shot. He is no doubt wearing some type of body armor. Okay, next up is Ren Roseless. Show this unappreciative man what you think of his comments.
Talking is a free action, right?
Talking is a free action. Just don't start reciting your family history.
Okay. Well, I have my gun aimed at him. Is there, careful aim or anything, to give
you
an additional bonus?
You can half-action aim to get a plus 10, and that would be that would be the first part of your turn, and the second part would be... you have your last pistol out, right?
Just yep, my last pistol has been drawn.
Indeed. So, roll to hit on your last pistol.
Well, I gotta talk to him first. You can't just kill somebody. You gotta
Fine. Say your free action.
What was his name again? I'm sorry, I forgot.
You know him as Skinner.
Skinner, your men are dead. Stand down.
That's the command. He will roll willpower against it with a minus 10.
I forgot.
He will roll willpower against with minus 10. Willpower minus 10. And submit. He failed horribly. Please don't fail as well.
Alright, so command with a 0 modifier?
0 modifier.
Fucking hell.
Oof. Fate point?
Yeah, why don't I just use these to auto pass?
This is the sass. Yeah, this is what this is what the automatic successes are for.
Yeah, I know, but I keep forgetting about them and click roll.
Yeah, when you really don't want to fuck up.
Fucking
hell. He does not look persuaded. But right.
I can still shoot at him, right?
You can. So, roll to hit.
I do have a modifier here, right?
Yes, so it asks for input half action aim.
It just says input value.
Are you... Hold on, let me...
Because I just clicked ballistic skill.
No. You go to your equipment and you click hit on the last pistol.
Out. So yeah. Hit. Half action aim. I also have them in short range, so there's an additional bonus
Point blank range.
So, okay, there's none of that.
It should say that. click next. You input the aim action first, then you input range, then you input the type of attack. I think that's how it goes.
Okay, so point blank.
Indeed.
And then standard?
Yes. Okay. Unless you wish to semi-auto him.
Nope, just standard shot.
Standard attack. Okay. So, holy crap! You have 1 degree of success. So, roll
damage.
Roll for damage.
We're the most inept inquisitors ever.
You're not inquisitors, you're acolytes of an inquisitor. Get it straight.
I'm a meat popsicle.
You do 1 wound. He is armored as all get. Alright, you are done. This guy is dead, so I'm going to remove him. This guy is dead, so I'm going to remove him. This guy, get bumped.
It's my turn to fuck it up.
Yeah.
Take his head off.
We are trying to kill him, yeah?
Yes.
Dead.
Alright. Yep. I'm going to cold shot. I'm going to cold shot at his dome.
Straight into his head.
Yep.
Go for it. So, half action to equip your weapon. Oh wait, you have quick draw. You can free action equip your weapon.
Did I get quick draw?
You have.
Yeah, quick I do. Yeah, I do.
You did something right. Right.
Hey, fuck you. All right. Quick. Yeah. So, rifle in the back, swing it around with it, and
half quick. Half action aim, I guess, because you really want to.
Yeah. This is a ballistic first.
You roll to hit on your rifle.
There it is.
Yeah. So you roll your half action aim.
Half action.
You are in short range. Short attack. The modifier that you have is +20 for your red dot side and your accurate weapon.
Yeah. So it would be short range. Instead of point blank, because he's what, 5 meters away?
No, it's 3 meters and you're four away.
Yeah, that's what I was asking, though, because I'm getting it says point blank, short range, standard, long, extreme, whatever.
Short range.
Point
blank. Short range. And when the final modifier comes up, it's +20 for you because of accurate and red dot sight.
Standard shot.
I think you have like 100 and something to hit.
It's pretty crazy. Pretty.
Yeah, cool. I don't think you can miss.
I got fucking close though.
Man, were you close? You could have critically failed that.
Yeah, I know. Which would have fucking sucked.
Shot ball in the back of the head.
It would have been hilarious.
Yes. Yes.
His body. You hit him in the body location.
Oh, but, I was aiming at his head. Called
oh yeah, that's right. Sorry, call shot. Oh wait, then you don't. Then you wouldn't have. Holy shit, you missed. Oh wait.
No, I don't take the penalty. Remember though, because I've got
no. You don't get the +10 for the standard attack. It's a call shot. You only get a +0. You actually missed. Do you want to fate point this?
Yeah, we're gonna say yeah.
That sudden realization.
Yeah. So,
Go. Okay.
Continue.
So and half aim, short range, standard attack.
Yeah. Well, we just have to remove the. Yeah, so just put +10 instead of +20 in the modifier because you lose the +10 from the standard attack. Whew. Yeah. So that's 63, that's 36, that's body location. You only have 3 degrees of success, so you get an extra damage die. So roll for me damage. That's 11. A roll for me, another d10.
That's one off game.
Okay, so pen 3, he minuses 4 from that, so that's 8. Holy fuck, Nuggets, he's not dead.
What the fuck is this guy made of?
Yeah, look, his armor... I mean, he did only take one wound from Alexis and Baal Tarwok, so keep that in mind. So, minus... But he is almost dead, just keep that in mind. Also, you shot him in the body location. He appears to be wearing... Oh yeah, you shot him in the head. Oh yeah, that's right, he takes an extra point of damage, so minus 1. So, he's even closer to death than it looks. You graze the left side of his skull. There is a nasty gash on it. Pew. Alright, so... Wait, hold on. I made a mistake. This guy was supposed to go before you. I deleted him because I thought that he had died.
No, you said he got rid of his action because he dodged the grenade.
No. That was his reaction. Hold on. I'm going to let you keep that action of yours, everything that you did, but I'm going to make him go now. So I'll just add a turn. So, no, wait. So, nope. God, effing fuck. Add turn. There we go. And I'll just pop him up here and give him 4 because he can. So, he's up. And he is going to fucking run for it. So, his run action is 24. So,
question: Does my shot to the leg alter him in any way?
It was not a critical effect, so no. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and he's out. So initiative ends for the tiniest bit, and it's time to start the chase sequence.
Someone grab the artifact.
I will do it.
Cool.
Who is going to grab the artifact?
Kirsch.
I will.
Also, you don't have to measure shit out anymore because you are free. You can freely move around.
Baltarok will pick up the artifact.
I'm going to run after him.
Did you pick it up?
I did.
Roll for me.
Did you cover it?
Roll for me. Willpower test.
That one.
All right. What do we got?
I'm currently resolving Baal Tarwok picking up the artifact.
No modifier.
No modifier. Whew, you make it. However, even if you do make it, as your finger touches upon the artifact, you are standing, and you blink, and you are standing before a great cathedral. Its towering grandeur seems to stretch impossibly towards the heavens. The area surrounding the cathedral itself is a thick forest scattered with graves in between, not dissimilar, in between. Upon closer inspection of this grand work of architecture, it appears to be constructed entirely from bones, save the heavy wooden doors at its center. Without anyone moving, the doors swing open. Inside, you see only darkness, and then two red burning flames appearing that are unmistakably eyes. They gaze upon you with bottomless hatred, and with a blink, you are back. Nothing bad seemingly having happened. Minus the hallucination.
Do I notice it? Because I'm
See, besides him picking it up and standing still, nothing appears to have changed about his. You can roll.
Sanitians
words. What was that, Knight?
I have a question. Do I remember this, or is it just something that was like a fading memory? Because if you not, I'd like to very much write that down.
You do not remember any of this.
Okay.
I can send you the thingy later with minor edits. Also, who starts running?
Me.
Brett said he would.
Move yourselves into the hallway so I can take note who is doing it. So, there you are.
That's not my full run. That's only 4.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know. But movement initiative has been suspended for now, so it doesn't count. So, it's only you.
Fine.
Only you.
Yeah, I'm going to stay behind. I'm in no position to chase.
Right. As I'm running, I'm going to open up comms and tell them to search those bodies. Check for any information on them that we can use.
All right. You heard the lady. Get cracking.
I'm going to go loot.
God damn it. All right, so.
I was debating that too.
My you guess.
Animals. Absolute animals, you.
The phrase you're looking for is murder hobos.
Yeah, well, we have a singular murder. Well, we have two murder hobos in this party. How I won't say which.
No, I'm staying back here and searching these bodies.
No, my bodies. I killed them.
So now we will be rolling. Hold on. God damn it. We will be rolling agility tests and a post extended agility test to see who can run the ahead of the other. You are trying to catch him and he's trying to get away from you. So,
any Brecht modifiers?
And no, this will be a no modifier test between all parties. So, a roll the first test and he fails. He's horribly.
He's fucked up and he trips.
Yeah. Well, you made 2 degrees of success. His, as you start chasing towards the limping Skinner, ha 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 ha, and Brecht does not make it. So keep count of how many degrees of success you have made. I will inform.
Wait, how many did I make?
You made 2.
Okay.
So, would I be able to re-roll that one by burning a fate?
You would not burn a fate point, you would use a fate point.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is your first fate point to use, I think.
Yep, this session.
Roll it. Or re-roll it, more like it. You got a 6. You had 4 degrees of success. Just take note that you need 6 to catch him, and if he gets 6, he escapes. All right, so let's roll another test and see how it goes. So agility, no modifier. He got a 7. He has 5 degrees of success. Apparently, noticing you, he picks up speed. He only needs 1 degree of success more to get away from you.
Can we take a shot at him?
You can try. Also important that you go to your weapons and minus all of the ammo that you have used in your clip. But you can do that when all this is done.
Okay.
So
can I, while I'm running, can I switch out to my las, long las?
I'm going to say
or am I
yet.
Just running with my pistol in front of me.
Actually, I'm going to say that it's not practical to run. You're going to have to sacrifice a degree of success if you want to pull out the long last.
Okay, so I can still fire with just the pistol normally.
Yes, normally you can do that because it's still in your hand.
Okay, so I'm going to try to shoot him with the pistol.
Right. So, do you want to sacrifice a degree of success to aim?
Well, I got 2.
You got 2, and you got another 1 from your latest roll.
Okay, how so many I have 3, I'll put out there? The 2 and try to hit him.
Yeah, Brecht, also roll your round 2 of the chase.
Is it a half aim or full aim?
Half aim.
Okay, and are we in point blank or short range?
You are in... I'm going to say that you are in... what's the one above short range?
Point blank, short range, standard range.
Standard range, that's what it's called.
Okay. I'm going to do single shot.
Right. Also, the modifier is minus 20 because he is running.
I can't do a modifier, so you're going to have to do this one for me?
Yeah, manually. Just manually then. We'll
input it. At the end, you should have a...
Yeah, no, she can't. She can't press minus 2 because the OBS fucks up.
Yep.
So, there you go. That's you, a miss. Yeah, that's a miss no matter what. So, pew! Straight into the air it goes.
Ooh. Can I command him to stop?
It kind of failed already. Kind of. Unless you want to try it again at a minus.
Well, I don't get minuses to commands.
Oh, yeah, that's... No, I mean, the minus comes from me, unless you want to fate point it.
I can, I'm all out.
Oh, yeah, shit, that's right.
I
have 4. Oh, yeah, she... Hold on. I'm going to say not at this point. The commanding of him has already failed. So let's see. You got 2 degrees of success, Brecht. What's that put you up to? Did you get...
I'm at 6.
You're at 6. Holy shit, you actually caught him. Pew! And you tackle the man to the ground and put your weight into his diaphragm, giving him a good kick at the same time. Okay, let's... we'll handle looting after the session. So are you going to drag him back towards the...
Yes.
Yes, okay. So start moving yourselves and him with it.
Can I help?
Can you help? Yeah, sure. You can help drag him.
Okay.
He appears quite winded and isn't struggling back. Also, Tarok, didn't you pick up the skeleton thingy?
Indeed, I did.
Yeah, he was the one that did.
Yeah, then just let me magic that away. Okay, let me tell you what these guys had on them. I'm going to tell you right now that they have, for their weapons, they have auto pistols and swords. You have better stuff than that. Just putting it out there. And roll for me scrutiny. Against perception. No modifier.
Is that for all the people looting?
That's for looting. That's for the looter boys. You've failed.
Yeah, no shit.
You failed horribly. And Tarvok? You fail as well.
Yay. Searching
their bodies, you find nothing of note except for their weapons. If you wish to take them, I won't blame you, but they are quite commonplace, and you have better stuff, so just keep that in mind. Just keep...
I take the auto pistol and basically hold in both hands, just making sure, getting a feel for using both of them at the same time.
Okay, fair enough. I will give
question.
You the... Yeah?
Can I loot, like, their mask?
Their mask?
Yes.
Well,
Or did the grenade fuck it up?
Yeah, I'm going to say that everything got fucked up. Including their mask. So, no. The only mask that isn't screwed up yet is the one belonging to Skinner, but it has a chunk of it missing from the sniper shot. Alright, so you can put yourself back in here. And you can drag him with you. So, is there a place you want to put him in particular, or just...
No, not really. I just want to see if he has any hint clues as to, like, who he's getting all this stuff from, or, you know, papers that may have some clue as to what's going on his person.
To me, it sounds like you're trying to interrogate him.
Yes.
Sure. So you can roll and interrogate with the plus 10. Actually, plus 20, because he's pre-effed up.
Never mind.
Can I just ask the princess to do it instead?
Okay, quick check. Does anyone here actually have the interrogate skill, interrogation skill?
I don't.
Nope.
I do not.
Fuck it. All right, I'll just roll it.
Yeah.
Pardon my language.
It is fine. He gets... Holy shit! I rolled a one. He rolled a crit on his resisting interrogation. I'm gonna say that his mouth is completely zipped. Holy shit. That was unbelievable. But
somebody get me jumper cables and car battery.
Yeah, about that.
Just took him up to the tech priest.
I'm gonna right here, stare directly at him. Just like while he's down on the ground being held down.
There's some blood leaking. Blood dripping from his mouth.
Can Toby loot his pockets?
I'm not telling you anything.
He's worthless to us.
Can I still loot him? Like right as he is?
No.
You are in possession of heretical artifacts.
You can take his weapons off him if you want to look for them.
By order of the Inquisition, I will grant you Emperor's mercy. I aim my pistol at his head.
Go for it. I'm dead already.
Shaking while I'm doing it.
Want me to do the princess?
Wait, Bryn, stop.
Toby, quick, get inside his head now before she does it.
No, what? I am... No.
Can I try to stop her?
I'm not doing psychic powers this time.
Do it.
No.
Seriously, this is the only way you're actually going to get some information from this guy, please?
I'm going to... Seriously, before she just fucks up, fine.
Before she kills him, please.
So I'll do... telepathic link.
Yeah.
Cast I use to...
You can...
modifier.
You can give yourself a plus 20 on this one because you only have to use one psi rating on this. Oh, actually, I think it does it for you, so only a plus 10. Only a plus 10, yeah, for your psi focus. Come on, don't fuck it up. I hate to break it to you.
Okay,
but that's
I have one fate point. Can I just fate point success it?
No, you can't. Look, if you fate point and reroll it, there's a chance you could fail.
No, use a fate point to automatically succeed?
Wait,
no.
Did he not pass it, though, because he rolled a 44 on a 48?
Yeah, here's the thing. Here's the situation. Yeah, he rolled a double, so he passed, bad stuff is going to... Well, potentially bad stuff will happen.
It's gonna happen.
Look, just take one for the team. I know you're taking a lot for the team.
I don't want to die on.
This is the part where Morgan Freeman's voice comes over and Tubby regretted playing Doc Ashley over Only War.
I don't like Morgan
Freeman. He's a cool guy.
Because at that point, Toby knew he fucked up.
Yeah, that's why you're listening to fucking Vig.
Hey,
Morgan Freeman.
Okay, so Morgan. What happens?
It works, but
it's going to work, but I'm going to need you to roll a D100 plus 10 for being demon bait. That's what you get.
Watch it be a 100. Okay, that's...
Okay, fair enough.
I hate you, V.
Veil of Darkness. For a brief moment, effectively until the end of the round, the area within 3d10 meters is plunged into immediate and impenetrable darkness. Roll for me 3d10. Actually, I'll just roll it real quick.
Why you do not trust the witch mind?
Crap, that was a wrong dice. So here, and roll. Ah. So, yeah, it's in a 11 meter radius. Then, stop rolling dice. Yeah, the entire room, effectively, is plunged into darkness for 5 seconds. However, as this darkness veils this room, you see in your mind a location. This would be the location that belongs to this whole thing character, and you would be able to find it again were you to look. Darkness passes. Princess, you're up.
Hand shaking, aiming right between his eyes. Emperor.
He grins straight back at you.
I pull the trigger.
Pew! Does she miss?
Do I actually have to roll to hit when I have a gun placed to his head?
You do not have to roll. This is an automatic success. And splat. He's dead. He lies dead upon the ground. Is anyone going to lampshade the darkness that just happened? Pun intended.
So, what the fuck? What was all that darkness just now?
I don't know.
It was an effect of the witch mind, obviously.
Okay, don't you have to roll science for something like that?
No, he would have to roll Forbidden Lore Psychers to know that. Yeah.
Could I roll to see if he's telling the truth or not?
I'm just going to assume my eyes were closed during the entire thing, because I was...
Yeah, I'm going to...
Well, I mean, he's not claiming it as fact, he's claiming, like, he's just making an assumption.
Oh, superstition, then.
Yeah, right. Oh. Right. Oh. Where's that at?
It's, hold on.
How would he even know I'm a witch mind? Oh, yeah, I freaked out when I saw the artifact.
Also, he knows, he knows about you. Everyone, I mean. You don't have Forbidden Lore Psyker, so... Sorry.
Tobian.
What was that?
What?
Can I roll Scrutiny on Tobian V?
Yeah, you can.
Do I need to roll Deceive the counter?
I'm going to say no, because... actually, roll Deceive against him.
No modifier?
The modifier is no modifier for either of you. So yeah, you make it. Well, you don't make it, but... You tell a lie, but... Toby and Brecht doesn't spot it. Yeah. It's like, yeah, you it's pretty obviously a lie, but Brecht is not sure. A glimmer of a shard of doubt still plagues his mind. So, this has been... how are we looking on time?
We are golden on time.
So...
About an hour and a half.
I'm going to say that we will continue next week.
Can I just add one more thing?
Yes.
While everybody's, trying to figure out what happened, Ren actually, drops her pistol and falls to her knees.
Roll another willpower test for me. Plus 20.
Because she is... really shaken by this.
Yeah. I wasn't even going to make you roll a willpower test, but you're... you get 3 insanity.
Okay. Where did I actually put that?
It's in advancements, of all places.
Advancements. Insanity.
I mean, It is an advancement, just in the wrong direction.
Yeah.
I'm going to scoop up her pistol and drag her off.
Sure. Towards the crate over there. Towards...
I was just going to move her back towards where we came in so she doesn't have to look at it.
It's below all of your thingies.
Oh, okay. Here it is. So what was it? Two or three?
It was three. There you go. Okay. So just move yourself and I'll move her. There you go. Boom. All right. This has been an interesting combat. I swear I did not plan it to be this one-sided, but the dice have a way of effing shit up. Plus, that was your only frag grenade, I think.
Nope,
so
I got another.
Fuck.
Of course you do.
Of course you do. Well, you know what to requisition now. Whole
grenade launcher.
Yes, indeed. Now, we'll call it for now, and we will see you again next week. Take it away, Alexis.
Anyway, guys, thank you for joining us for another episode of Queen's Court. I'm a miserable crybaby right now. Anyway, I'm Alexis Diego Queen. I love you guys. Bye.